Sometimes you use a product that just says wow when you create. This is what happened to me when I discovered Lindy's magical powders. Yes, they're called magical because they almost work like magic to create beautiful projects. And in this video, I will show you not one, but five ways to use Lindy's magical powders in your projects. Technique number one, mixing them with water. For example, you can sprinkle some dry powder on a paper. The one I'm using is heavy watercolor paper. And then all you do is you add water. The second way is that you can dissolve some powder in a palette to create your own watercolor. Maybe a clean palette, not like mine, because the powders could reactivate with the water even after they've been dried for a while. So you want to make sure your palette is clean. What I have here on my palette is acrylic paint, so that's permanent, so it won't reactivate. The third way you can use them this way is by just adding water to the paper first. I use a spray bottle for all these techniques. And then I sprinkle or paint with it with a very soft bristled paintbrush. The last way you can do this is by simply dipping your wet brush right into the powder, but make sure you use very little bit because they're very potent. Let's get into technique number two. I'm following technique number one because it is combining the magicals over texture. Texture that I created with either a medium or with stencils. Here I'm splitting the paper into two categories. I will be adding some crackle paste, and on the other side I will be adding some modeling paste. I want to show you how the magicals react over smooth surface paste and texture paste. And the beauty of it is that you can create texture either with a medium or with stencils. So this will be a combination of more than one technique. When I add the magicals, the color goes inside the crackle paste, creating a beautiful texture, going through the design pattern of the stencil. I just love this technique. It's one of my favorites because it creates the most beautiful designs on your projects. Technique number three, making paint with them. Yes, you can make paint. You can combine the powders with clear or white gesso to create a thick medium that looks like paint. You mix the gesso with a little bit of powder and then use your paintbrush to apply it. The colors are so bright and magical, and some of them have speckles in them, so they are even more unique. This is a great technique to quickly cover a background and imagine using it with a gel plate. Wouldn't that be amazing? But that technique is for another day, as this video is jam-packed of other techniques. If you mix them in an airtight container, you can definitely reuse them again and again. Just make sure you seal it really well, because they act like acrylic paints, as gesso is acrylic based. Technique number four. Following the third technique, you can mix them with modeling or texture paste to create a colorful medium to use with stencils. You just mix it the same way as before with the gesso and can store it for later use in an airtight container as well. Then you use it with a stencil the same way you would use any modeling or texture paste. Imagine making different colored paste and combining them together. Wouldn't that look so pretty? Look at the purple. Isn't it so bright and beautiful? This is how the pigment mixes with the modeling paste, and it creates a beautiful, colorful 3D effect. Imagine this with your favorite colors. The fifth and final technique is also quite simple. You can mix the magical powders in a plain water bottle to create your own unique sprays. Although Lindy's already has their own sprays with some colors in each set, they are a little bit more subtle in potency than the magicals. This will also save you in having to buy sprays as well. All you have to do is take an empty bottle, fill it with water, and then add some powder. The more powder you add, the stronger the color will be. Make sure you shake the bottle side to side so the powder doesn't clog the spout. Then all you do is spray it and you get a beautiful, easy, and quick background. Just remember that magicals are not permanent, so you need to seal them afterwards with either setting spray or what my friend Nuneka recommends, which is the Tim Holtz Microglaze, which I will link below in the description area as well. So when you use magicals with just water, like in the first two techniques or in the last one, you need a setting agent. If you're mixing it with another permanent product like gesso or paste, you don't have to seal them as they are permanent. Here are some more videos I created with the Lindy's Magicals. Check them out right here.